Hello children, have you seen this type of situation in your school? Have you faced any discrimination based on your gender, color or caste? Nowadays, you might not have faced this type of situation. We don't have any discrimination based on caste, gender or color. All boys or girls, men or women, enjoying equal rights in the society and in all aspects of life. Girls can study equally with boys. Have you ever thought of how children lived about 200 years ago? 200 years ago, things were very different. Most children were married off at an early age. Girls and women had no access to education, no right to property. People were discriminated on the basis of caste and creed. People used to worship many idols and perform several religious rituals and other superstitious practices. They were orthodox. In the 19th century, India witnessed a strong wave of reformation activities in religion and society. There were attempts made by the educated young Indians to end the evils and abuses in religion and society. They tried to remove the flaws in their culture. They tried to revive the glory of Indian culture. In this video, let us see some of the social and religious reform movements of modern India. Raja Ram Mohan Roy was the pioneer of socio-religious reform movement in modern India. He founded the Brahma Sabha in 1828. It was renamed Brahmo Samaj a year later. The Brahmo Samaj was an assembly of all those who believed in a universal religion based on the principle of one supreme God. Brahmo Samaj was the first rationalistic and intellectual movement in India. Its main aim was to reform Hindu society. After the death of Ram Mohan Roy in 1833, the Brahmo movement was led by Devendranath Tagore and Kesho Chandra Sen. They popularized their ideas by giving lectures all over India. Another important reformer of the 19th century was Ramakrishna Paramahamsa. He was a priest in a temple of Kali at Dakshineshwar near Kolkata. He preached the unity of all religions. He stressed that every individual is a part of God. Therefore, according to him, service to man means service to God. Swami Vivekananda. He was a chief disciple of Ramakrishna Paramahamsa. In 1897, Ramakrishna Mission was established by Swami Vivekananda at Belur near Kolkata. The mission's motto is Service to Humanity. It serves for the education, upliftment of women, removal of poverty among the poor and downtrodden. The mission has opened many schools, technical institutions, orphanages and hospitals. It has branches all over India and other parts of the world. It also rendered service to the people in times of distress caused by natural calamities like flood and famine. Swami Vivekananda made a solid contribution towards Hindu religion, culture, society and Indian nationalism. The Ramakrishna Mission therefore became a strong movement. It is still doing useful services to the Indian society. Now, let us know about the woman reformer Savitri Bai Phule. Savitri Bai Phule was a social reformer who, along with her husband Mahatma Jyotirao Phule, played an important role in improving women's rights in India during the British rule. Savitri Bai was the first female teacher of the first women's school in India and also considered as the pioneer of modern Marathi poetry. She also was the first woman to light her husband's fire in the history of India. Savitri Bai was a Vidya Jyoti for all those who want to do something in the field of education. Another woman reformer of the modern India was Ishwari Bai. She was an Indian politician, a member of the Legislative Assembly and President of the Republican Party of India. She worked for the upliftment of the backward classes who were subjected to slavery and caste discrimination for generations by the upper castes. She was elected as a councillor of the Secunderabad Municipal Corporation in 1950. She established a vocational work centre for women and trained number of women in tailoring, spinning, knitting and other crafts. Bhagya Reddy Verma was one among the reformers of the caste system. He was the father of Dalit movement in Telangana, worked tirelessly to make Dalit people aware of their plight and fight for their rights. Bhagya Reddy Verma founded around 26 schools in around Hyderabad region for Dalits. In 1906, he started Jagan Mitra Mandali to educate Dalits through popular folklore. Mandali worked on the social consciousness among untouchables. Later in 1911, he founded Manya Sangham, which tried to create awareness among untouchables through literature and lectures. Bhagya Reddy Verma had launched a movement against Devadasi system, forcing the Nizam to declare it a crime.
Other reformers like Kandukuri Veerashalingam, Swami Dayananda Saraswati, Sir Syed Ahmed Khan, Jyotiba Phule, Narayana Guru, Dr. V.R. Ambedkar, Arige Ramaswamy, Pandita Ramabai Saraswati, T.N. Sadalakshmi, tried to get rid of complex rituals, worshipping of many gods and idol worship. They also tried to eradicate social evils like sati and child marriages. They encouraged women education and widow remarriages.
Hello children. Now it is time for evaluation. Improve your learning by answering these questions. What are the main objectives of Ramakrishna Mission? Do you think people have accepted the reforms of modern India? Explain the role of Savitri Bai Phule as a woman reformer. Why Vagyareddy Varma was called the father of Dalit movement in Telangana? Hyderabad was no less in women's participation in political movements. Comment on it with reference to Ishwari Bai.